Hi, I'm Mark Needham with StarTree, and in this video we're going to learn about JSON indexes in Apache Pinot. One of the cool things about Pinot is that while it's mostly used for structured data, we can store semi-structured data as well. And this is useful for storing things like metadata or nested data where some of the values may be missing or empty. Let's have a look at how we'd go about ingesting that data. So we're going to use the kcat command line tool to query a Kafka broker. The topic's name is people, and we're just going to get back three records, and then we'll prettify them using the JQ tool. And so what you can see here is we've got a timestamp column, we've got a person, and underneath the person it's got all the nesting. So you can see we've got an ID, we've got a name, we've got an address, and then notice, like, for interests and friend IDs, those are sometimes missing. So what we're going to do next is we're going to get that data into Pinot. So we're going to start by looking at the schema for our table. So if we start, we're going to name the schema people. And then if you look under dimension field specs, we're going to have a column called person, and it's going to have the data type JSON. And so that indicates, yeah, we're going to have some JSON data in here. And then we go down, we've got the date time field spec for timestamp. Let's next have a look at the table config. So you can see right at the top underneath table index config, we've got JSON index configs. And so this is a new parameter that was introduced in Pinot 0.12, and I think it makes it much easier to define JSON indexes. And what you've got to do is you've got to specify the name of your column. So in this case, we've got person. And then we've got some different properties that we can adjust. So we've got max levels. So how deep do you want it to go into the array? We can choose whether or not we include or exclude arrays. We can choose whether or not to disable cross array unnesting of the data. And then sort of at the bottom, we can choose to include paths, and exclude fields. If you put null, as we've done for the there, it's going to include everything. And it will do these in combination. So we're basically saying we want to get everything except for the age field. So we're going to exclude that one. And if we scroll down the file, we can see we've got the rest of the table config for connecting to Kafka. Now let's create that table. So we're going to call the add table command. And we'll give that a few seconds to run. And it says, hey, we've got our people table ready. So now let's come on over to our Pinot UI. Let's start with a simple query. We'll just say, hey, I want to get some records from the people table. It won't take too long to run. And you can see, there we go. We get back, and you can see under the person column, you can see all the nesting of the records. Now let's have a look at how to use the JSON index that we defined. The JSON index is used when we use the JSON match function in a where clause. And as of version 0.12, it works for equality, inequality, and then in and not in arrays. And if you use it on a column that doesn't have a JSON index defined, it's going to throw you an exception. So let's get started. So we're going to say, hey, I want to select some records from the people table where JSON match, and then I'll give the name of my column, so person, and then I've got to give it a JSON path expression. So in this case, we're going to say, I want to go the address, state is Kentucky, and we'll get back 10 records. And you can see it does it very, very quickly. And we can, if you look closely, you can see there we go. We've got a bunch of records where the state was Kentucky. Let's do another one. So this time we'll just count the number of records. And this time it's where JSON match, again, the name of the column, person. And this time we're going to check whether the state is not Illinois. And then we run that, and you see again, very, very fast, and just over a million records. Let's do another one. So this time we're going to use the JSON extract scalar function to pull out the address, state, to pull out the state from the address. And then we'll do a count of how many times each one's coming up, where the state is either Kentucky or Alabama. So we're going to see how many times are each of those showing up. And you see we get back the records. We've got roughly 25,000 of each. Notice this one is a lot slower than what we saw in the previous one. And that's because we're using the JSON extract function, and that's having to run for every record. So be careful when you're using that one in combination with the JSON match. Make sure you don't do it if there are loads of records coming back. We'll do the same thing, same queries again, get the state count, but this time where it's not in Kentucky or Alabama. And so you can see this time we get back some different ones. We get North Carolina, we got Nebraska, we got Arizona, and we got some other ones as well. And then finally, we're going to do one where we count the number of records where we sort of go into an array. So this time we're saying I want to do a JSON match on person. We're going to go into the interests and get just the first one and check the first one is swimming. And you can see we get back roughly just under 60,000 records. And so that's it. That's the end of this video in which we've learned about how to use JSON indexes in Apache Pinot. Give it a try and let us know how you get on, and I'll see you in the next video.